Oh my goodness, what does he mean? Par car. And he was like, what? What alcohol? Pacifier. Dummy. Americans never speak like this. Hello everyone. Today we'll be talking about American English versus British English. We're gonna discuss five main differences. Pronunciation differences, spelling differences, differences between collective nouns, vocabulary differences, and differences between past tenses. But before we get started, I want to tell you that there are more videos coming on English Lessons with Kate, so please subscribe to the channel and click the bell so you'll be notified as soon as I publish a new lesson. The first part we're gonna talk about is, of course, pronunciation. You probably know that British people and American people pronounce things in extremely different ways. In Britain, most people don't pronounce the R sound. The letter R is only pronounced when it's followed by a vowel, like in words red or wrist. And in the United States and Canada, people always pronounce the R sound. Either the R sound is in the middle or at the end of the word. Park, park. Car, car. Stare, stare. Care, care. Fair, fair. Well, in British English, the R sound is dropped if it goes at the end of the word or after a vowel sound. Another important thing is the sound T in American English becomes D if it goes between two vowels. Let's look at the examples and compare American to British accent. Water, water. City, city. Potato, potato. Reality, reality. Letter, letter. Creative, creative. As you can hear, British English sounds completely different. I love British accent, but American one is much easier for me, and I really enjoy the way it sounds. It's like music for my ears. And now let's dive in the second part, which is spelling differences. You've probably worked with Microsoft Office. It's a program for creating documents. And if you write a word color, the word gets underlined with a red line, like there is a spelling mistake. But this is not the case. The reason is MS Office has American Dictionary as default. And it's extremely important to know spelling differences between American and British English. And in this part, I want to teach you some of them. In British English, for example, some words have extra letters, like words favor, color, neighbor. In American variant, we drop the U sound because we don't pronounce it. In American English, we write verbs like analyze, organize, realize with ze at the end. And in British English, it will be with se, like analyze, organize, realize. The next difference is tre and ter at the end of the words, like center, theater. So tre is American and ter is British. The next part is differences between collective nouns. In British English, collective nouns can be either singular or plural, but in most cases they are plural because when we're talking about a team, a family, a band, we mean a group of people. So in British English, people say, my family are going to London tomorrow. We're using are because the noun family is plural. But in American English, collective nouns such as a family, a team, a band is usually singular, and it's very common to say, my family's going to London tomorrow. But there is one exception. Police is always used as a plural noun in American English. So they always say police are, for example, the police are going to be here any second. Even when native speakers mean police as an organization, as a department which is responsible for protecting people, they never say police is or a police. That's grammatically incorrect. Now, let's talk about vocabulary differences. If you don't know all words and phrases with different meanings, you can find yourself in a very embarrassing situation. When I started to study English, I was focused on British one mostly. And one day I had a text conversation with my pen pal from the United States, and he sent me a message where he wrote, "I was pissed off because my mother took away my laptop and told me not to play computer games anymore." And I was like, oh my goodness, what does he mean? I didn't know what to say because I opened Cambridge Dictionary and found this word, and the definition of the word pissed is drunk, and I didn't really understand. Why is he drunk? How come? He's only 16. And I asked him, "Do you drink much alcohol?" And he was like, "What? What alcohol?" And after a while, he explained to me that to be pissed off in American English means to be annoyed, to be irritated. And there are so many things that have different meanings in American and British English, and we need to learn them because these differences are incredibly important. Here is another example. I got a flat. In Great Britain, a flat is a set of rooms for living in, and for a Brit, that phrase has a positive meaning, right? And in American English, a flat means a flat tire, a tire without air inside. When we're talking about cars and driving, a tire that the air has come out of. So in American English, the phrase "I've got a flat" has a negative meaning. Also, British people can use flat as an adjective. When we're talking about the batteries, a flat battery is a battery with no electrical power left in it, whereas in the US people say a dead battery. Now, let's have a look at some words that have different names in American and British English. Subway, underground, cell phone, mobile phone, elevator, lift, apartment, flat, closet, wardrobe, diaper, nappy, cookie, biscuit, sneakers, trainers, eggplant, aubergine, pacifier, dummy, French fries, chips, sprinkles, hundreds and thousands, broil, grill. In American English, to broil means to cook something under a very hot surface in a cooker. And in British English, this thing called to grill. And cooking something over a fire or hot coals with the heat coming from directly above or below the food. The American would say, for example, "Broil the steak for 5 minutes." And British people would say, "Grill the steak for 5 minutes." And now let's talk about the differences between past tenses. There are also grammar differences with past forms of irregular verbs in American and British English. The past tense of learn in American English is learned. And in British English, two variants can be used, either learned or learned. You can also make a choice, dreamed or dreamt, burned or burned. In American English, the ed endings are common, and Brits tend to use t endings. In American English, the past participle form has the en ending for some irregular verbs. For example, an American might say, "I've never gotten that opportunity," whereas a Brit would say, "I've never got that opportunity." And let's mind the pronunciation here. Let's say it with a British accent. "I've never got that opportunity." Americans use both got and gotten in the past participle. Brits only use got. Don't worry about these small differences. It's not that important because people in both countries can easily understand you if you say either learned or learned, got or gotten. And now let's talk about some grammar aspects. If you're gonna go to the United States, please don't forget that in America, people don't use tech questions at all. It's nice weather, isn't it? This phrase is good for the British. And if you say this phrase in America, it's gonna be kind of weird. Americans never speak like this. It's normal to say for Brits, let's have a picnic, shall we? But did you know that Americans never use shall we as a tech question? Sometimes Americans do use right at the end of the sentence, but right is not so frequently used in the UK. So, I've told you 5 important differences between American and British English. It's obvious that there are more differences in terms of vocabulary and grammar, but I think it's gonna be too much for one lesson. Well, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. And now I have a question for you. What's new information you've learned in today's lesson? Please write a comment down below. I always read all the comments and I'm thrilled to get feedback from you guys. If you like this video, please hit that like button. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye-bye.